Hello, Dominic from BMT Spain, and today I will try to explain a little better the swing pad for the topspin or kick surf. There were some questions about the swinging from left to right or towards 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock, and also if you swing too much from left to right, you have no power in the ball. Now, I will start with the swing pad. This is my swing. But all this for me is not my swing pad. The swing pad for me is the part where I really swing at the ball. So you can say, the moment you start to stretch your arm or you have that elbow extension towards contact and a small part after contact. So this is my swing pad. And if you understand this, then it's easy to explain that swinging from left to right or to 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock is very easy. It's even very natural if we can control our sideways position. Now, I will show you two different ways what I mean with natural. If we want to throw a ball and I will have my power position, if I want to throw to the front, which will be actually my flat serve, my elbow, I call it the elbow kicks in. Some coaches will talk about you have to lead with the elbow. So if I want to throw, the elbow kicks in, but also the body starts to turn. And for that now, my arm is pointing more to the back and I can swing from back to forth, or let's say from 6 to 12. So if I have here from that power or trophy position, a good start, the elbow kicks in, I turn and I throw, and you can see my swing pad is to the front, is in the direction of 12 o'clock. So here we have a serve of Kyrgios. Let's check out the position of his arm. And as we can see here, the arm is pointing backwards. Now from here, he will make his swing forward. So we will see that the swing pad will be in the direction of 12 o'clock, as you can see here. Also, we have here an example of Medvedev, the arm pointing back, and he will go direction 12 o'clock. So swing pad forward, and the side view from Serena, arm is back, and also that forward swing pad. Now, the kick serve, we will throw more from left to right. So if I do that same kick, but I control my hip and my shoulder, what happens? I have this motion. And now you can see that my arm is pointing to the left. So here we have a serve of Federer, and let's check out his position. Does he stay sideways? So here we have that position, hips and shoulders to the back, and the arm is pointing to the left side, so ready to go to the right side. And now it will be very natural from in that position to throw the ball in that direction. So here we see that he's making the swing to the right side. So the swing path is going from left to right. And watch how the body is still pointing to the side. So no problem. Even I can swing or throw that ball into the direction of 1 o'clock. If I take this position and I make this, now I can throw the ball to 1 o'clock. I make this position, I can throw the ball at 2 o'clock. And again, the same. From here, I can throw the ball at 3 o'clock. So no problem for swinging from left to right or 1 or 2 o'clock if you can control the sideways position. Now, if you're going to check out this serve at normal speed, you would think there is a lot of hip and shoulder rotation. But if you are going to check out a little closer, you can see here that the sideways position is still in his place. The hips and the shoulders are back. The arm is pointing to the left side, the hand is behind the elbow, so he can stretch up very fast. And as you can see, even after the contact point, the hips and the shoulders are still in the position sideways. Here we have the same, here we have Rajonic, and as you can see, also here, the sideways position, the arm pointing to the left, and from here, he will stretch to contact. And as you can see, even after contact, he still has that sideways position. It is possible to turn a little bit, but I will explain that in another video. But for beginners, and intermediate, even to advanced. Try to keep your body sideways as long as possible. Then, if you want to make a natural throwing action, even without thinking of serving, just by throwing, you want to throw the ball in that position, you will do this. This is a throwing action. So what happens, as you can see, the elbow kicks in, and now the hand comes behind the elbow, and this is where you will find a lot of power. Now, the ball has no speed if you go from left to right. Well, if you only go from left to right like this, you are right. That ball has spin but has no speed at all. The problem is that this only happens with people who squeeze too hard on the racket. Even if that elbow kicks in, yeah, up, and you squeeze too hard, that racket stays in that position. So I will make a serve, squeezing hard on the racket. As you can see, indeed, I have no power. But this is not what's happening if you hold the racket like you should hold it, loose. And if you have that elbow kicks in, the racket doesn't drop to the front. The racket drops more to the side. And because that elbow kicks in, that racket will kick to the back of the court like this. Now you see the racket is pointing backwards. We can check out some pictures of professionals where you will see the same. Check them out. So, because the racket is now pointing to the back and my arm is pointing to the left, I can stretch my arm. And if I stretch my arm or I start to make my swing motion from left to right, you will see that there is the forward momentum of the racket to that contact. So, from here, I have forward momentum, and this is my power I put into my stroke or my spin. Yeah, so if I do this slow, so I go here, I do this slow, I already have a nice good serve with a little power. Now if I start to control my swing and I go faster, now you have a good topspin serve. And I made more speed by stretching faster. So that you have no speed swinging from left to right is not true if you hold the racket the way you should hold it. Now, also, it's not because that the racket drops to the back that you cannot swing to 1 o'clock. Also here, I will make that same relaxed motion here. My racket will kick back, and now I will swing towards 1 o'clock. So this was, for me, 1 o'clock. Now, let's swing more to 2 o'clock. And as you could see, 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock, the ball goes more to the outside with enough power. So, to repeat, if you can stay sideways, it's no problem. It's even natural because your arm comes in that position to swing from left to right or 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock. And if you hold the racket not too hard, you will have that flick of the racket backwards, and this is where you will find the power, that forward momentum towards your contact, and the faster you can stretch, the more power you will put in it. So to finish, I have here a nice video of Dimitrov and Federer next to each other. Let's check out the 2 points we have just discussed, the sideways position and the racket that flicks back. So here we have the side position from both the back view and the side view. And also you can see with Dimitrov that the arm is pointing to the left side. In Federer's case, the arm is pointing in our direction, the back. And the body is both pointing to the side of the court. And from here, they will get that elbow kick. And as you can see, the racket flicks to the back. And you can also see with Dimitrov, the arm is still pointing to the left and still pointing to the back with Federer. And from here, they will make their swing pad to the right. One a little more to 2 o'clock, and Federer more to 3 o'clock. So, I hope this has become a little more clear. If there are any questions, you can put them in the comments, and I will do my best to answer them. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Just give you one more note.
So if you are interested in playing college tennis and get a tennis scholarship, do not hesitate to contact Decoa Sports. Its founder Raymond Covis can help you to find the best university where you can keep playing your favorite sport and be granted with a scholarship that can cover up to 100% of your college costs, including everything, tuition, room and board, books, insurance, and so on. They have been assisting international tennis players for more than 18 years. So, free to mail them at rcoves@decoasports.com, and for further information, check out the website decoasports.com. Once again, thank you for watching. See you in the next video.